Hello guys, today I'm going to explain to you about the thermal desorption tube. This is thermal desorption tube that already being ran from the nearby laboratory. So this is our tube. So the first thing that you need to make sure is your tube have a similar serial number. In this case it's 203011. So it's same with the allocation number given by the chemist in the laboratory. So the first one, you need to uncap both of the end using your fingers or apparatus given by the laboratory, and then you need to open it nicely for both end. Okay, open the cap like this. After you open the cap, so there are some notation here. So this notation here indicate that you must make sure that your pump is away from this area. So that means you need to put your pump here. You need to attach the tube of your suction is here, and then this is from the inlet of the air. You also can refer to this arrow indicate that the positions of the air being withdrawn from the outside into the inside chamber. So after that, we are going to set up our apparatus. So I'm going to use the Jillian air pump, personal air sampling pump, setting for the low constant pressure module. So we're going to use the sampling tube holder to make sure that the locations of the sample is being representative. So after that, I'm going to open the pump, and then we need to sample according to the required flow rate and then required times. After maximum volume is being achieved, then we need to detach. Before that, you need to off first your sampling pump to detach the thermal desorption tube, and then you need to recap it back. So the first thing that you need to recap, you must make sure that you not tighten up the tube so hard, so that it will damage the lining of the tubes. Okay, in this case, I'm just going to use my hand, just a hand tighten condition. Okay, so if you see, they got some lining there to prevent the leakage. Okay, and then we make sure that we tighten up it very nicely like this, and then it's ready to be shipped out to the nearby laboratory. So you are going to use the aluminum foil or anything that can prevent the UV light from reacted with our sampler. Okay, after you wrap it nicely, and then you need to put inside the container, contents of the material, cooler box lah, preferably cooler box, which is setting up by the 4 to 6 degrees Celsius. And then you are ready to fill up the form for the chain of custody, and then don't forget to send to the nearby laboratory as soon as possible. Okay, that's all. Hopefully you can understand this process, and hope going to see you. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel.